3D Wonder Woman Acrylic Nail Art Tutorial by Hotpinkzebrapolish.
Hi guys, in today's video I have a two nail little set to show you, and it is for Wonder Woman. So the first nail has 3D Wonder Woman sculpted, and the second nail is the little Wonder Woman logo that's partially color blocked, partially 3D. I hope you guys like it as much as I do, and don't forget to click subscribe to see all my future videos as well. Bye!
I'm going to begin the Wonder Woman nail by creating an overlay of white acrylic. I actually did this, the white acrylic overlay, on both of them. So just start out with a very thin coat of white acrylic and go down the nail just like so. And then after you have that done on the Wonder Woman nail, I'm going to encase it with a layer of clear acrylic to make sure it is nice and strong. You don't have any other colors going down on this one, so you don't have to worry about adding anything else to it. Just add that clear acrylic and encase that all the way down. After that's in place, you're going to want to file the nail into shape with your e-file, starting out with a coarse bit to remove any bulk and just going over the whole thing. Especially if you do an encasement like I did with two beads, there's going to be a little bit of a, I don't know, you can tell where the one bead stopped and the other one started. So just make sure that that's filed smooth. And then after you have that done, go over with a finer bit and just remove any scratches that first file may have left behind. It's never quite as smooth with a coarse bit. Obviously, I mean, it's a coarse bit, so that fine bit does a lot of work for you. Then I'm going to take, with a light beige color acrylic, I'm going to begin sculpting her face and her neck. So just sort of work on creating her. When you're doing a design like this, you want to start, maybe you don't, but I always say you want to start with the most important element of the design, in case you run out of space one place or another. So typically with a character, I would say the most important part is their face. Now, if you want to do a design that really focuses on, say, her outfit, I would start, you know, with her torso and then work your way out, because you never know exactly how big things are going to get. Every once in a while, something doesn't go quite how you planned. And if you start with the most important element of the design, if you skip something else, it really doesn't matter. It's not that big a deal. So as you're sculpting, go all the way down and sculpt her entire body. You don't worry about sculpting in her outfit at this particular moment. Just worry about getting all of her different shapes on. So add her chest and her arms, shoulders, and you can go as in detail as you want with this. You could keep it fairly simple and fairly flat, or you can actually add some dimension like I did. Now I'm going to be adding her hair with black. And her hair in the end has a lot of a teal highlight to it. So with this, you could really sculpt it one or two ways. You can do what I did and do black and then add teal to it. Or you can go the other way and do teal and add black to it. And that's up to you. Her hair really is black with the teal highlights on it. But it wouldn't matter because it's almost 50-50 in the end. So you can do it however you like. So add her hair with little bits. The one downfall of using black acrylic is that if it gets somewhere else, if it gets on the white background or on her skin, it's so much harder to remove. A teal would be easier to clean up if you needed to. So that would be the main reason that I would do it that way, in case somebody was wondering exactly why I would recommend that. That would be the reason if you were concerned about having to deal with cleaning up smudges from the black acrylic like I just got right there on the side. So that would be the only consideration. Just go over like that. Then I'm going to be adding her top with red acrylic. So the benefit of having a really nice built-up base with her flesh tone underneath having the top on it is that you don't really have to worry about making the top very thick, and it just blends on perfectly, and it can very easily sculpt her clothes on. Otherwise, if you didn't want to, you could do more of the building up in the dimension with the red acrylic at this point, but it's up to you. The other benefit, or the other thing that you could consider with doing it the way that I did, is if you didn't want to use red acrylic to sculpt it, that you could definitely have done just a paint on top of it and do it that way. Then I'm going to take yellow acrylic and sculpt her headpiece. Really, my yellow acrylic, I say this every time I use it, I don't really like my yellow acrylic because it's not very pigmented at all, and it pretty much looks like a weird mustard beige at this point because so much of her black hair shows through. So you really do have to clean that up with yellow paint later, especially if yours looks like mine. Same thing with a little bit of yellow that is on her top below that. Yeah, all the red shows through and ends up looking orange. So now that I'm going to start doing my painting, my hand painting, I'm going to begin with yellow and cleaning up all of that little mess that my yellow acrylic caused. So just go through like so, and then I'm going to be adding little bits more of yellow details. So add the W on the top of her, Just continue those lines all the way down like that. Go right across the chest with that pattern or with that design. And as you're doing this, Like I said, you could have done the whole thing with red paint and not worried about sculpting any of the top at all. This would be the stage where you would do that. You would probably want to start out with painting a red base and then adding all the yellow details. Now I'm going to be adding all of the teal in her hair. So just go through and add little lines here and there. This is where you add the hair texture to it, and this is where it really adds dimension and looks like that iconic DC Comics appearance that really gets that Wonder Woman appearance in it. So just add all of those little teal stripes and then go through. I'm adding a little bit more yellow here and there because yellow, just in general, whether it's paint or acrylic, isn't always as pigmented as I would like it to be. And then I'm going to take some black paint and I'm going to be adding little outlines here and there with somebody that is a comic book character. They're heavily outlined. Don't go easy on the outlines. Just really outline every single thing that you'd like to. Go through, add some more little outlines around her face, outline her collarbone and some little lines on her neck. Do a couple little dashed lines for some shading on her neck too if you want. Like I said, comic books have a very distinct appearance to them, and to try to replicate that I think is a lot of fun, and you just have to really make sure that you do have plenty of black lines and plenty of extreme highlight and low lights, which is where those little lines on her neck come in and where the teal in her hair comes in, is kind of that extreme highlight appearance. Take some more of that black, and you're going to need to add all of her facial features. And if you're a little cautious about using black paint, you could do it in the style that I did for my Disney Princess series, where you took and do some black or some brown outlines before you go through and do the black ones, so that it's a little easier to correct an incorrect brown line than it is to fix a black line. So if you want to, that's definitely a way you could do it. But I think doing that Disney Princess series gave me some more confidence, and I just went straight to black with this one. So after I've got all of those facial features sort of all sketched in, I'm going to fill them in, add some color. I'm going to fill in her eyes with white and then add some red in her lips, just like so. And like I just said, I think that Disney Princess series gave me the confidence to go straight to the black lines. If you guys have something that you're not super confident in, like for me, that would be painting faces and painting people, which I would always say is the case. They're not my first go-to thing if I'm going to say what I think I'm the best at. But you just have to do it. And that's kind of scary and intimidating. But as long as you just are like, you know what, I'm going to do this and force yourself into it. Like for me, getting myself into that full year-long Disney Princess series, it really kind of can get you over that. And even if they're not that good, just keep at it and eventually they will be. That's my little inspiration talk for the day. And then I'm going to be adding a little star with red on the top of her headpiece. Apply some gel sealer over the background, cure that. Apply some matte top coat over Wonder Woman. And then I'm going to work on the logo nail. So this nail at the moment just has a very thin layer of white acrylic in the background. Then I'm going to be sculpting a red circle right in the middle of the nail. Try to keep it as perfectly circular as you can, which I know can, you know, nobody's perfect, so getting a perfect circle isn't necessarily the easiest thing. And if that's the case, go ahead and take a very straight-edged hand file and go around the edges and smooth them out so that they are nice and crisp and straight, and it's as close to a circle as you can get it, which this will definitely help out because you can easily see what side needs to be brought in a little bit. After you have that, brush off any of that little dust that may be hanging around on the nail, and then take some blue acrylic and place it right down on top of your red circle, and then sculpt a blue circle around the red one. So when you're doing this, you have to kind of tuck the acrylic around that red edge and then just press it down. And depending on what kind of acrylic you're using, mine, I can see sort of a shadow of where the red circle is, which helps me know what the thickness is of the blue circle that's going around it. So that helps. If your blue acrylic is so opaque that you can't see that, you may want to do this a little differently and just add acrylic around the outside edge and not completely cover up that red circle. Same thing, clean up the edges with a hand file if you need to, which, you know, let's face it, you never hurts to sharpen things up a little bit, and then take and dust off the nail again, and then case the nail with a layer of clear acrylic. You don't have to do too much of that in the very center where that little not polish color blocking is, but around the outside, the top and the bottom of it definitely needs to be built up a little bit more because it just has that thin layer of white. After that's done, go ahead and file this. This is where it is really fun because you can start to see the design show through. You want to use a very coarse bit for this because otherwise you're going to be filing for a while. So just go ahead and file till that design pops through. And like I said, this is so much fun. I absolutely love doing color block designs where you can do what I consider to be a file to reveal, because you just get this moment of, oh, look at that, there it is. And all your hard work finally paid off. Go over with a finer bit to smooth everything out, just like that. And then I'm going to take some yellow acrylic. I'm going to be adding the 3DW. So to start this, you're going to want to start with almost like a little arrow shape. So you're going to have, or an upside down V kind of, but just add that first little bit to it and sculpt that, place that down, press it into shape, and then add the little wings of the Wonder Woman off to the side, the wings of the W. Sculpt those. You want this 3DW to have enough height to it that you can tell that it's 3D. So you don't want to sculpt it pancake style and make it really, really thin and doesn't have that awe factor that you're going for. So you want to make sure that you're using enough acrylic that it does have some height to it. Because otherwise, if you weren't going to do that, you might as well just have sculpted this in the beginning and done the file to reveal with it and not have worried about doing the 3D element of it at all if it's not very thick. So just make sure that it's thick enough. If you want to kind of sculpt in the little wing shapes on the edges with the tip of your brush, you can. Otherwise, you can do that just with paint. Either way, so then there you go. Add a layer of yellow paint on top of the yellow acrylic, because if yours is like mine, as I have said already, it's not going to really look as bright and clean as it would with a layer of acrylic paint on top of it. Just go through and add a little bit of paint to sharpen up the edges and smooth it all out. A little bit more on the sides. That really makes everything just look so much more vivid. Then take some black paint and add all the little details, outlines, so on and so forth. Just like with the Wonder Woman nail, like I said, don't be skimpy on the outlines. Same thing here. Really do outlines. Make sure everything is very exaggerated. Add the little lines within the Wonder Woman logo. Going through just like so. Bring those down and around. Add the lines going around the whole thing. Really make them nice and crisp and clear. And then I'm going to be applying a layer of gel sealer over the background and cure, and then some little matte top coat over the W. Then using jewelry gel, I'm going to be attaching some little silver star rhinestones, 3 above the W and 3 below, just going around in a nice little circle. So just place those little dabs of jewelry gel down and then grab those stars, place those down as well. And then after you have all of those in place, you're going to want to go ahead and cure it. Just like that, and that's it. I love this combination. Like I said, I think it has a classic comic book style to it, which I think is just so fun. If you guys are Wonder Woman or DC comic fans, I would love to see recreations. Please share them with me, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!